Hello, everyone. My name is Wang Yuyang, and I'm from Beijing University of Technology. The topic of my presentation is human physiological signal detection based on LSTM. My presentation will include these five parts. Introduction, method, experiments, results, and conclusion. First, let's the first part, introduction, in the context of the rapid development of the time. People in all fields of life are concerned about convenience, life, physical health, and life safety. And the young people, nowadays, the young people under great pressure in work. And busy young people can't always pay attention to the physical condition of the elderly at home. So the wearable devices provide safety guarantees for the elderly. The smartwatch detects any physical condition of the elderly and feeds it back to the family members' mobile phones. It is practical to analyze their age reactions index by wearing smart watches and adjusting the status in time. So what is the HRV, heart rate variability analysis? HRV signal contains much information about cardiovascular regulation. The injection and analysis of this information can quantitatively evaluate the tension and the balance of cardiac sympathetic nerve and vagus nerve activity and its influence on cardiovascular system activity. So HRV analysis method generally includes four domains, time domain analysis, frequency domain analysis, linear analysis, and nonlinear analysis. Our paper choose two domain to analyze the information, the time domain feature analysis and the frequency domain feature analysis. The part two, the method. Now let's see the previous research. I show the three previous research. Spiritually in 2018, in 2020, and 2021. In previous studies, there are very few articles that analyze the human mental state through neural networks, and many of them use machine learning to analyze the degree of relaxation of the human body. So this article used the LSTM network in deep learning to analyze the degree of relaxation of the human body. This is our data acquisition process. The wearable smart watch can obtain the pulse signal and then analyze the pulse signal. We can get the RR interval. Analyze the R interval through the HRV, we finally get the 27 dimensional date features such as SDNN, HF, LF, and LF divided by HF. We use this data, or we send this data to the LSTM network for deep learning. And this is our data analysis. First, some abnormal data exist, such as the shaking and the instability of network signal. So we must process the abnormal values. And the features selection, I will show on table one the classifications of each reduction index. I will show on table two. And this is the explanation of the H relax index. The H relax index is used as an index to measure the body's degree of mind and mind relaxation. This is the table one and the table two. Table one, typical characteristic reference value in the 5 minute measurement data. SDNN, LF, HF, LFNU, HFNU has a more significant impact on the age reduction index. So I choose this 5 feature. The table one shows the 5 feature, the reference range. And the table two is the 3 classifications of age reduction index. Part three, experiment. This is our training process. First, we get the data source and standardize the data, divide the training set and build model. This is our design of the model. And then we train model. This picture shows the report is the first report the value. Through training model, we can get confusion matrix and classification report. The article mainly explores the long short-term memory network results on the age reduction index multi-classification problem compared with SVM. LSTM has a better classification effect and higher accuracy. This is our LSTM network. In table three, the effect of modification of batch size and the report on experimental results. In this experiment, 18% of the data set is used as the training set. The running time and the accuracy of the test set are observed by modifying the iteration and the batch size. In the figure one, we can see when the report number exceeds 200, the loss of the verification set is overfitted. Maybe there. And this is the bidirectional LSTM network. This section adds two-way LSTM network layer to the network design. And in figure two, we can see when the number of reports exceeds 100, the loss of the validation set is overfitted. Result. This is a comparison of LSTM network and SVM network. Running times, test accuracy, recall, and FE score. Conclusion. Experiments show that when the number of iterations is 300 and the batch size is 500, the accuracy of LSTM is 0.94 and the running time is 118 seconds, but there will be overfitting. Therefore, when the number of the iterations is 200 and the batch size is 500, LSTM accuracy rate is 0.92. So the running time is, the running time is 79.2 seconds. The LSTM network proposed in this paper is better than the previous SVM measure to classify the body relaxation index. So we have the 3 conclusions. It is feasible to conduct data analysis on variable reaches through natural networks. Second, through the improvement of the LSTM network structure, the addition of the bidirectional LSTM network did not make the accuracy rate better than the previous results and more time requirements. The application of variable witches in hospital and in home has practical significance. Future work. I think there's three points that we should do in the future. The first is the simple data set is too small. So maybe we will collect more data to our experiments. And second, find extra feature inputs that affect the H reaction index and add them to the original data to make the original data more complex to improve the model's accuracy. Third, explore the possibility of the bidirectional LSTM network structure to improve the experimental results. This reference and acknowledgement. Thank you.